Hey, I'm back in the NAHB Next Lounge. I'm with Brandon Patterson. Found Brandon on LinkedIn. There was a photo of him with Mike Rowe. I'm a Baltimore guy, so I had to look into it. Brandon's doing an amazing amount of just crazy work all over, but I want to talk about the skilled trades gap and what he's doing with Iowa skilled trades. So, Brandon, what's up?
You know, in Iowa, we have something really special going on. We have a privately funded... Sorry, I had to pass that off. We have a privately funded school within a school, and all of the local surrounding schools have been able to send their kids there to learn niche things like culinary, skilled trades, automotive, everything. Obviously, I'm involved in the skilled trades portion of it. The skilled trades portion, we raised $1.7 million in less than a year. And that, nobody can touch that. So if there's budget cuts or anything like that, if everything that doesn't touch this school, so the skilled trades will continue to flow. So our goal the first year was to have, 100 students. I think we're at 140. Max capacity is around 300, and we're there right now. So we're in need of expansion, and we are expanding. So we're starting our second marketing campaign to go out and just source some more money. As far as what we're doing for fun things, we did bring Mike Rowe in. We were able to raise $90,000 just for scholarships that night alone. We are going to use some of that money, besides the scholarship money, to form a website, iowaskilledtrades.com, all for career readiness, scholarships, open jobs, anything like that. We want to create a network where people feel comfortable just getting involved and getting engaged in the skilled trades. And that's kind of what we're doing. I mean, we're working on a lot of stuff. We're going to do Dozer Days next and then create something like an IBS at a local level, maybe like a JLC Live, but in the Midwest, because there's not a lot of stuff in the Midwest where people can come and, get involved in the skilled trades and learn more and grow their businesses. And we want them to stay, in the Midwest.
So. Fantastic. So, amazing work you're doing. I appreciate it. If you're watching, I feel like this is a future returning the favor. So, keep that in mind. But Brandon, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.